Good afternoon, everyone. This is Christy with Van Auten Company. It's Friday, January 3rd. I'm going to go over the market for the day and week with you. So just when things really start rolling and looking good, an unplanned event really usually starts to interrupt things. And that happened here overnight when the U.S. decided to use a drone strike to take out a top Iranian official. Now, this has nothing to do with grain and meat markets, but it put a landscape out there for traders to really take a risk-off mentality. We came into the new year really feeling quite content, quite satisfied with the general landscape of the market. You know, everyone is pretty happy with the economy. We feel pretty good about the U.S.-China relationship with the signing on the Phase 1 deal coming up on the 15th. And so everyone kind of just felt a little bit comfortable, and you get something like this to shake it up and people kind of step away from the market. And that's what you really saw happen across the board. So corn market down 5 cents today, soybeans down 14 and 3 quarters, Chicago wheat down 5 and 3 quarters, Minneapolis wheat down 10 and 3 quarters, Kansas City wheat down 10 and a quarter. Really across the board, that's also what happened to the meat market. So, but on the week before you had today, you had a positive week for a majority of the grains, but it did shift things a little bit. Corn on the week down 3.5 cents, soybeans still posting a penny higher on the week. Chicago wheat down 1.75 on the week. Minneapolis wheat down 6 cents. Kansas City wheat down 4.75 on the week. So you did get a little bit negative. Some of the charts aren't looking the best right now after today's reversal action. So we'll have to see what Sunday night into Monday brings. But there is a little bit of an unfriendly tone around this market. Now, next week is a very big week for grain markets with the January 10th crop report on Friday that offers a lot of details and is really going to dictate how trade goes for the next couple weeks. Meat markets, like I said, also risk off mentality there. Live cattle down 80 cents, feeders down $1.30, lean hogs down limit, lower of $3 on the front contract. On the week, however, live cattle able to be positive of $1.22.5, but feeders down $2.20 and lean hogs down just over $2 on the week. Cash trade, though, was friendly for cattle. Live was $1.24, up $2. Dressed was $1.99, up $4. Hog index is really kind of sitting stable, slightly lower from where we started the week off. So really, besides today, it's been a positive week when you look at these markets, but today kind of shuffled a little bit and got that risk-off mentality. So it's a big weekend trying to see what happens, what's to come from this airstrike. Iran said they are going to retaliate, so we'll see if there's anything more to trade off of in the meantime. Otherwise, really, we thought 2020 would start off with a bit of volatility. We weren't expecting quite this much right away, but it is what you're seeing and really setting the tone for the year. I do have to close with the disclaimer: trading futures and option involves risk loss and is not suitable for all producers. This is a solicitation. Have a great day.